Well, the first day of the third quarter, and with the S&P 500 in mind, the enduring bid for risk assets persists. Traders continue to recognize that some of the tailwind is coming from the Fed, and what they did say, or perhaps what they did not say. It seems like now, the latest Fed speakers, perhaps less urgency with rolling out any kind of yield control cap or steadfast concrete forward guidance. It's really been a boon to risk assets and knowing the Fed is ready to pull a lever and they have levers at their disposal. And yet that's driving yields down and stocks higher as we speak. But the big news today was ISM manufacturing beat to the upside, new orders strongest since 2004. We also saw a rebound in new orders to inventories, and that's the widest level since 2009. Employment did increase, but still remains below 50. That said, the ISM for this week continues to be a big number for S&P 500 traders, given how much consumption has carried the day, at least in the second quarter. September also picks up where August kind of left off, with like the Uber technology and growth stocks well bid throughout most of the day here at the CME and definitely providing momentum to the S&P 500. Now going forward, traders that look at technicals want to know the short-term support resistance levels. And right now, the first support for the September future stands at 34.84.50. Followed by the second support pivot zone of 34.70. On the upside, the first resistance point would be 35.19 even, closing decidedly and convincingly above that. The next level we'd see is 35.39. Options implied levels down most tenors today, but interesting, the first 3 months in the S&P 500 future options also seeing skew down and also tail down. So you're seeing the 30 delta put, 10 delta put down as well as the implied volatility. Many times implied volatility drops and we see skew or especially tails rising, but a general selling along the curve, especially on the downside puts between a 35 delta and the 10 delta.